Hello everyone, welcome or welcome back to our channel. If you are deciding to pursue an MSc in Business Analytics, well, you are at the right place. Today we'll be talking all about MSc in Business Analytics from one of the world's best known prestigious colleges, that is Imperial College London. We will delve into the class profile, tuition, the entire admission process, followed by some important and interesting facts and figures about the careers and so on. So without any further ado, let us get a master's of the admission process in MSc in Business Analytics. Located in the heart of London, Imperial College London was founded in 1907. Since then, it has its eminent focus in medicine, engineering, technology and business-related fields, which makes it one of the top most demanded colleges all throughout. Now on to the business analytics program that we are discussing, that is offered by Imperial College Business School, which talks all about the intersection of data and technical aspects to business and real life decisions and how these interlink and perform a brilliant amalgamation which really solves all the world's topmost business problems. Now talking about the rankings a little bit, Imperial College London in itself has been ranked second according to the QS World University Ranking 2025, whereas its particular program has also consistently been in the top 10 according to the latest QS World Ranking. Apart from that, London in itself has been ranked as the number one city to pursue all these business related fields and all the educational programs in general, which is really a good news for those who are deciding to go to London and start their career. Now to talk about the core modules. So basically the core modules of the curriculum in general has an eminent focus on the technical oriented fields such as data visualization, data modeling, machine learning and all of those aspects which are really techie in nature. But if you really get into it in detail, you will be really interested because these will help you build a foundation that really helps you add up the business aspect of it. Also, the interesting electives will help you further your interest in the specialized field of study. So talking about advanced data analytics, or to talk about marketing analytics, or to talk about finance analytics, all of these programs really come together and make you a really good and equipped data analyst in the future as well. Also, in the summer term, you will be completing your analytics in business capstone, wherein you'll be delving into the real life aspects of all the studies that you have had before the summer term. So you will talk about all the projects, research projects or the corporate projects, and also enhance your working experience before you really get into the employment stage of your career. What does the class profile look like? So 2023 to 24 class profile had around 95 students, which means this particular class had 95 students, which could be plus or minus for your particular class profile when you enter. These have an average age of 23, coming from various nationalities, that is 26 countries throughout, with a 60 to 70% ratio of women, which is a really positive sign. Now, after all these details, you really want to know how do you really apply. So basically, we'll follow a 3-4 step. In the very first step, you need to start your application. Very common thing to tell you. But you go to the admission portal on the official website. And therein, you start your application. You fill in the basic details and you submit around £100 of application fees, which is non-refundable. Then you come to the second step, wherein you need to answer a few questions. So the questions have been asked as per the three aspects. So basically, you start with your career planning questions, talking about why are you really pursuing this course? What are your future goals, etc. Then you come to your quantitative question answering, that is all the skill set, the quantitative or technical skill set that is required, a preliminary skill set that is required from you. And then you answer number three, all the computer and all the very computer programming related questions, which will sum up all of your question answering. Then we have the long list of supporting documents that will support your application and you as well. So firstly, you need to submit your degree to them, telling that, hey, you have completed your particular degree, which is their requirement. Apart from that, you need to submit another list of documents, that is your personal statement. You can refer to the official website as to how do you really curate this personal statement and give it a human touch. Followed by that, you need to have your referees. So you give the contact details of your referees. It can be two academic or it can be one professional, one academic, but the contact details need to be submitted. Apart from that, you need to submit your CV or resume, which has to be a crisp, short account of all your professional experiences. Followed by that, your two test scores, that is GMAT or GRE, and the English language test score if required, that is the TEFL or IELTS. Then if selected, you will be notified by the admission committee and your application will be complete. And you will be admitted if you are really serious about the submissions. Talking about the tuition fees, so MSc Business Analytics tuition fees, apart from the latest number that we have, is around £41,000. Yes, it's a really huge number, I know. Apart from that, your deposit has to also go additionally, which is around £4,100. Also, a good news is that there are numerous scholarships offered by Imperial College London, particularly for this program or in general as whole. So you have the African Future Leader Award, you have the Black Future Leader Award, you have the Female Future Leader Award of Scholarship. Then you also have their Excellence in Academic Excellence Award of Scholarship. So you should really go and scroll through these scholarships and see where you align and definitely apply for them. Talking about the career, so really good news is that 92% of these graduating in the 2023 batch were employed within 6 months of their graduation. Approximately 40% of them were employed in UK itself, and around 20 to 30%, approximately 27%, were employed in finance. Talking about the top recruiters, you have McKinsey and Company, you have Google, you have Amazon, you have Goldman Sachs and whatnot. So now, since Imperial has a good and huge tag attached to it, you will be really recruited if you show interest to them. So is the Imperial's Master in Business Analytics program the right fit for you? That is for you to decide. But this was a summary of all the facts and figures and all the requirements that you are needed. And hence, this was a deep dive into Imperial College MSc in Business Analytics program. If you like the video, let us know. And also, stay tuned as we explore another such Business Analytics program from another such top school in the following video. Apart from that, if you're really interested, you can also explore our other videos on the channel. Thank you. See you later.